Hey everyone, what's up? It's Rob Dotson. Today I'm going to be taking you one step closer to building your own single page application by showing you how to handle URL changes with a client-side router. So let's dive in. So if you've never heard of it before, routing is the process of determining what code to run when a URL is requested. In the world of routing, there's basically two approaches. You can do all your routing in JavaScript, and that's what I'll cover today. This is called imperative routing. Basically, you listen for a route change. When you hear it, you run a callback function. And inside that callback, you can do all sorts of things. You could tell core pages to change which item is currently selected. Or you could set a bunch of scope variables and update your bindings. And there's also declarative routing, which I'll cover in the next episode. Basically, this is doing the same thing, but using markup instead of JavaScript. Now, the difference between imperative and declarative routing really comes down to style and personal taste. Polymer doesn't have an opinion here, so I'm going to start by showing you how to do it imperatively. Next episode, we'll do it declaratively, and then you can decide which you prefer. The first thing I'm going to do is hop into my terminal and install a router called Page.js using Bower. Then in my index, I'll load Page.js with script tag. And scrolling up a bit, you'll see that I've got a similar code from my last video. I've got a core pages element inside an auto-binding template. I've dropped links in the show notes to that previous episode, so you can review it if you need to. In my core pages here, I've got a value attribute set to data route, and I've also got a selected value set to a scope variable called route. And what this is going to do is it's going to look to see if any of these children match the current route. So if the route was set to portfolio, it would see which child has a matching data route attribute, go down, and display this one right here. Now, hopping into my app.js file, I'm going to grab a reference to the auto-binding template and just store it in a variable called app. Then I'll call the page.js function to define some routes. And lastly, I'll configure the router to use hashbang URLs instead of the history API. And what this means is that my routes are going to have a little pound symbol and an exclamation point on the end of them, versus just using pretty URLs, which might just have a slash and then the actual name of the route. And the reason I'm going this route is because it doesn't require us to set up a server. Pretty URLs will, so hashbangs can be a little bit easier to work with. But I encourage you to try both out in your application. And the last thing I have to do is write out the functions that'll run when these routes match. So I'll create functions for home, portfolio, and contact. And you can see that these functions match the routes up here. Inside of these handlers, you could run all sorts of code. You could fetch data, or you could redirect to other routes even. But to keep it really simple, I'm just going to tell my template to set its route property to a matching string. Now, hopping in my browser, you can see that as I update the URL here in the address bar, the content on the page changes to reflect it. Pretty simple, right? All right, the last thing I want to do is toss in a menu so the user can actually swap between the different sections. Let's check it out. Now, I've gone ahead and dropped in a core menu and bound it to that same root scope variable as my core pages. I've also included anchor tags in my menu items. So when a user clicks on one, it's actually going to trigger the router to update the URL, which will then set the route variable. Now, because the core menu and core pages are both using that same route variable, effectively the two are linked, and they should update in sync. Back in my browser, you'll see that as I'm clicking on these different menu items, the URL is changing up here in the address bar, and the content stays in sync with the rest of the page. I can even grab the URL and drop it into a new tab. And once that boots up, you'll see that the content is showing the right page and the right item is highlighted over in our menu. OK, so you've seen the first bit of routing that's possible in a Polymer project. And at this point, you're probably ready to just like run off and go build your own application. But don't run away just yet. In the next episode, I want to show you how to do all of these exact same tricks using nothing but HTML. So definitely stick around for that. And be sure to click the subscribe button. It is how I justify my employment here. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.